Servus.
Ma'am, it says here you were born in 1908. That makes you 45 years old.
That's right.
Adeline Marie Bowman was born on January 1st, 1908. Many years later, she would begin a family of her own. On a cold winter night in 1935, Adeline's life would change forever. In that moment, something incredible happened. Its effect was almost magical.
I kind of want to talk about one of the things I thought was really great about Ellis is that he is so engaged in being in a relationship with Jenny slash Adele.
Yes.
Adeline. I'm sorry. But it was so natural because it felt like, you know, he acknowledges it's only been a week, but I feel this passion. Can you talk a little bit about finding the right tone for that character and the right, like, element of how much you show and how much you don't?
Well, you know, Ellis is this kind of guy who basically has it all. You know, he's young and successful, and he's like Mr. Perfect. You know, he's a philanthropist, but he has like I said, he's made a fortune with some algorithm, but he has this beautiful apartment, but he's renovating it himself because he wants to do something with his hands. I mean, I thought that it was important to kind of undercut that and make sure that he wouldn't take himself too seriously, mm-hmm. because otherwise we would think, like, really? And otherwise Adeline would also never go for him, I thought. So that being said, I always imagine him, you know, he's had girlfriends and several relationships, but he's never found the one, mm-hmm. you know? And he finds, or he sees in Adeline, someone that is so strong, beautiful, and has such depth, and she's also very mysterious mm-hmm. to him, obviously, because she's hiding the fact that she's actually 100 years old.
107.
Thank you. 107 years old. But to me, it always made sense mm-hmm. that he would be so persistent. Now, I wanted to make sure that he didn't come across as a creep, so I hope...
Yeah.
I hope.
Well, it also, what I thought was really interesting with him is that he has nothing but time. And that's one of the things, is because he does his philanthropy, but he has time for her.
Yes.
And so he has this time to kind of pursue her in a way that in other romantic films, we don't really have that chance to see the fact that it actually makes sense.
Yeah.
That he could really put the effort into being patient with her.
Yes. I don't know. To me, that the way he's being patient with her and just, you know, their overall relationship or the feel the movie has, it gave me this old-timey mm-hmm. Hollywood feel, you know, which I really liked.
Yeah. Well, and that's actually really funny. I have a note in here. I was like, Blake's costumes are so pretty. And then hers are just so timeless in a way, and then as with yours, but were you kind of disappointed that you didn't?
What do you think of my costumes?
Oh, I thought they were, I mean, they were fine. They just weren't as glamorous as Blake.
Don't worry, you can say anything you want. They weren't as glamorous. No, not at all. Yeah.
And I just was curious as a performer, and I know costumes are such a big part of, like, the part of finding characters and coming from Game of Thrones and having really cool costumes there.
Yeah. Well, I think my costume on The Age of Adeline served a purpose too, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, the car my character drives is this Saab that he bought when he went to college, you know? This guy has made a lot of money and doesn't really care for that, for those kinds of things. And I thought that would add to, you know, this character being interesting, a very interesting guy too, you know? Mm-hmm. And maybe interesting enough for Adeline to give up her her solitary life.
Yeah. Well, and it's also like her timelessness and his timelessness that it meets each other really nicely.
Thank you so much.
Can you talk a little bit about working with Harrison Ford?
Well, I mean, just like it was one of those moments that I would probably never forget. You know, if this was my last movie, I can still say I worked with Harrison Ford. And that was a pretty awesome experience. And it wasn't like it was another movie on his roster of blockbusters. You know, it was fantastic to see that he was so passionate about this project, mm-hmm. and about grounding our characters, and really forced me to step it up. You know?